Welcome back, everybody, to DBD League. We got Luminescense versus Divine Dead, Yokat on the Blight on Bloodlunge, and Dire, he needs to find someone as soon as possible. We know exactly how it is. Blight likes to play early chases, early downs, and maybe that's exactly what he's going to find right here. Quick tap coming on to Tree Trick.
Tree Trick is realizing that this Blight, YokatX, is not joking around. Immediate injury, just three rushes into the game. 40 seconds here. The first chase going out kind of the outside of the map, and that's going to be a very unfortunate quick down. Not even able to use any resources here or get into a little bit of safety. Very, very unfortunate start. Cropped intervention, though, that's now expired. That's the good news here, but I do think the plan for the early game was something different. We do see a pop goes to Weasel as well, so YokatX starting off with the first chance to cut out a little bit of pressure. That's the next injury coming out.
It is, and Cursive already being injured is such a huge deal here. Slow vaulted the window. I'm assuming there's a life bar or something that he didn't want him to be worried about, but that does mean that he might be prone to going down right here. Beautiful vault coming in right as of there, and that was the pre-drop coming down as well, making that a realistic opportunity. But how many pallets can you actually pre-drop before you're gonna go down? The answer was two, and that's Curzip down. Meanwhile, Tree Trick does get unhooked and might just get healed instantly as well. Yep, that is the case, but only, I'm sorry, not even one gen being done yet, and the basement is also in main building. So this is a big, big problem here for the side of Divine Dead.
Very big problems in the early game. Yeah, the Blight really, really oppressive, coming out perfectly here in the early game. And we mentioned in the campfire chat, Bloodlunge usually coming in with a few resources to use for the survivors, but unfortunately Divine Dead not able to connect these together. We do see one generator here with a lot of progress, and our killer decides to not go after this survivor, instead applying the pop goes to Weasel Kick. A very smart decision, if you're asking me, and also making it just in time back towards the shack here, where the survivor has just been rescued. So potentially a deliverance now in play, but I don't think you worry too much. Godcon is just going to take the injury, and instead we will see Killsep going to face the tunnel out. Quick break with the brutal strength as well. An interesting pick on the Blight, and what a beautiful juke though coming out. And this was an important one though, because this chase here needs to cut out a couple of seconds from the killer, and winning here once again. This mind game now so important for Divine Dead, and looking quite good, but unfortunately Quentin now going down once again.
Yeah, and honestly, kudos to Curzib. He lasted just about as long as he could. Did a beautiful fake out right to left onto a pretty open area, which is what Blight loves the most to rush against you at. So beautifully, beautifully played. And finally, a generator being done here. And was it the same one that he actually applied eruption to? I think it was probably. Yeah, it was. It was the one that he popped and eruptioned onto. So that means another generator is probably being done somewhere else. And there it is, the second one being popped as well. Is Cursip just going to be sacrificed from here on, though, Dire? I'm not sure what the best possibility is here for Divine Dead.
Yeah, now is the time in the VC where you start looking for alternative plans, where you do start to try figure out who's the next survivor we should also throw into the chase, because someone needs to protect Cursip here. The survivor that was just 20 seconds away from elimination is now going to face the Blight. Once again, P100, Quentin, what a beautiful swing right there, but that's going to be the mending effect. Cursip going to stay alive a little bit longer. Either you do pull a survivor over to help your teammate, or at least you crank the generators, but Cursip once again with an very, very strong juke here, absolutely shining. Divine Dead facing a difficult situation, and Cursip just casually pulling these god moves when the team needs him. Will he make this pallet? Ooh. The answer is no, unfortunately not. Maybe there's a pallet safe, but that would be quite risky to set up. So I do assume, yeah, it's just going to be the elimination. However, we do have three generators at this point repaired, potentially a fourth one with more pressure. So it still doesn't look too bad, under the condition that the next chase is relatively long.
Yeah, exactly. The next chase needs to be long. Tree Trick needs to not be found, because he would be the perfect opportunity here for YoCat. Menox and Vidcon are, however, probably on the opposite side of the map, because that's where the generator popped. And the question is, do they have progress on any of the other ones? If we could try to flip through all the survivors and see if any of them are in position, it doesn't look like they are. No, they did get the healing off, though, done onto Tree Trick. And now it's just going to be a matter of time before Yokot finds someone. And here, scratch marks, pretty fresh. Might be able to find someone, but actually decides to just go on the opposite side of the map, because no 3-gen really to be found, but this is quite the area, or this is more the area where he actually has most of his gens right now.
Now we do see Nia here, Tree Trick, being aware that the killer is coming around, waiting, and we do see that they are doing a perfect move around the Palantir, able to stun the killer and gain a little bit of distance. Yokot X is going to take care of the generators, prioritizing the objectives here. Just taking a quick look. We don't have a Pop Goes the Weasel kick until we do hook the next survivor. But Nia once again running into his field, and that's going to be the next whiff. Beautifully playing around the pallet here. One time is stun, next time you're just running through it. So not making yourself predictable for the killer here. Next attack coming out, almost juking it, but Tree Trick staying with the injury, but Yokot X very likely just going to defend these generators here. Good sign for Divine Dead. They are putting up efficiency left and right.
They definitely are, and I mean, are they on these generators over here? We do see Menox hiding, because we do see the Blight being in the vicinity, so might be the smarter play as of right now to just play it slowly, try to play a little bit of hide and seek, not really give any opportunity to be found. But Tree Trick hasn't really gone anywhere. He's still in Shack, and he is going to go down, and I do believe Goodcom was also found right here. That means big problems, because if he does get a hit onto him as well, it's gonna be insanely difficult for Divine Dead to do anything, let alone get one person out. One hit going in onto Goodcom, and that means no pallet save can really come through unless Menox is actually in position, and maybe we even go for the slug to try to get the double down here, Dire.
Yeah, the double down would probably be some sort of an endgame opener here, because as soon as two survivors are down, the last one carries so much responsibility. Now Menox being caught as well, but Godkan made it out of the difficult area here, so potentially we will see the killer just going back. Yeah, picking up Tree Trick here. You do want the hook stages that you have available to yourself, because you also want these Pop Goes to Weasel kick. When you're trying to defend your generators, make the most out of the perks you have. So I like this decision making, allowing Divine Dead on the other hand to go for the reason, but reading that Godkan hasn't left the area. No, we had just talked about how bad it would be if we have a double slug, and now we're not talking about a double slug, Nico, we're talking about a double hook right next to each other.
How did he know?
And why would you stay in the locker?
Yeah, I mean, that's just insane intuition here coming out. I mean, of the Blight, that's so unbelievable. I would have never guessed that anyone would have been in that locker, but I guess the thought process is that if they want to get this unhook in any form or any capacity, then, well, they have to be really, really close outside of the bus, or at least at the locker. Beautiful, beautiful read here coming out of Yokot, and that's Tree Trick 100% going to be sacrificed, because if Menox shows himself in any shape, way, or form, he is for sure going to get downed as well. And yeah, Tree Trick for sure sacrificed. Goodcon probably also just going to be left for dead as well. I mean, is there any play to be had here for Divine Dead?
I was just about to say, maybe you can just get the fourth generator done while the killer's enjoying his work over there, because then you would at least force the other team to at least break the 3-gen, and they need all generators done, but that's not going to be the plan here. Menox just going towards the unhook. They are trying to play this again as two individuals and potentially getting the last generator through that, but Blight not too far here. Once again, I want to circle back to the situation we just saw. I do get that you want to stay close for the unhook, but hiding in a locker is always a very, very risky move in Dead by Daylight, because if you are caught, especially as a healthy survivor, it's an immediate down, and if you are healthy, you better hide behind a tree or something else. So if you get caught, you just take the injury and not the immediate down here. Very unfortunate decision making on the side of Divine Dead, using the chest here that randomly spawned, making the most out of the resources that are given again. Beautiful game sense by YokaDex. Quick down onto Godkan. Once again, Mannox now again the final standing survivor with all the responsibility. And I do think, Nico, when we talk about the last chance, that's going to be an endgame play with the exit gates.
Yeah, it might just be because Hatch is about to spawn here over at Shaq, if I'm not mistaken. And that, well, that's just too easy for Yokad. He is already there. The chase got taken over there as well. So he's just going to close that immediately. And now it's all on Mannox. Is he going to go for it instantly on these gates? Or is he going to try to do the 15% that we always talk about? Is he going to try to sneak his way into it? But I think he can actually see it from here. Yeah, I think he has line of sight from that hill dire. This is never gonna work.
Now this is just brutal, and that is really, really sad for Divine Dead. Perfect map layout here. For that going to realize that as well, I believe. Seeing that there's the hill, you can see the blight beautifully as well, and he caught it. Yeah, there was the movement in the back. Claudette now not going to be able to get this. The last challenge would be to go down by the endgame time and not by the killer. In terms of the points, it wouldn't change anything, but it would change something at least in terms of not allowing YokaDex to go for a clean 4k here. You can say, okay, you needed a little bit of help by the endgame collapse, but looking on how YokaDex played this, I also think this is going to be a very, very quick finisher.
Yeah, definitely. I respect it so much by Mannox. He knows that his faith is 100% sealed. There's not really much he can do at this point. He's just going to go down at a matter of time. And yeah, YokaDex can just chill and do whatever he feels like. Big respect coming out from both players, though, it seems. They're having fun with it. That's always super nice to see, Dire.
And important, right? Because Divine Dead now, with the difficult situation, like the win condition will be 4 generators for Luminescence, so they don't even need to worry about a 3 gen. And if you get a little bit of fun out of this and can put this into your killer and kind of relieve the pressure, not going into the next match and say, okay, you have to go for the tie condition, we want to replay this. Instead, you could say, okay, this was a fun trial, didn't work out for us, it was fun. Try what you can, play the best, and your killer can go in without the pressure. Maybe he's even more able to pull some magic here. But so, Nico, this is going to be an incredibly difficult task.
It definitely is, and we just have to wait and see what the killer of Divine Dead has in store for us. Obviously, it is a blight, so anything can happen. There's a lot of chaos that ensues the moment you put in a tier 1 killer inside a trial, but we will be right back after a short break with the second set of the blight.
Ladies, gentlemen, pup warlords, and competitive enjoyers, we are back with the second trial between Luminescence and Divine Dead, with the blight on the Blood Lodge and a very tricky win condition here, especially for Cursive on the side of Divine Dead, because we just need 4 generators. That means you can ignore a 3 gen on the side of Luminescence, the most beautiful win condition that could exist, and also getting a quick injury, though. That's going to be the good news for Cursor, but we kind of need the quickest double down in the history of Comp DBD.
Yeah, we definitely do, and we do see the Fung here, Waxat, doing pretty well here. There's a lot of pre-drops coming in, though, so a lot of these pallets are going to get eaten up really, really fast by the Blight, no doubt about that. Oh, he misses on what he wanted to bump up off. I feel like that's going to give a little bit too much distance. No, it's not. It was all a ruse. Waxets, it's going to go down here to Cursive. Beautifully played here by Cursive. Honestly, I don't know if that was a little bit of luck on his side or just, once again, 500 IQ play. It definitely looked good in the end, at least.
Yeah, and getting the first hook stage that quickly is going to feel good for Divine Dead as well. You do have to... Pop goes to Weasel and the Brutal Strength as well, paired with the Eruptions. We do see an identical build compared to trial number 1. Catches a survivor back there, but you want to go for the tunnel out just to care off the generator right here.
Oh,
that looked like they tried it for the people, if I'm not mistaken, but didn't get it off in time. And that was a beautiful read, but unfortunately the weapon is not long enough. Twice in a row, and that's going to be a third and a fourth rolled over the pallet here. You need to catch that. A third whiff coming out. You need this survivor, but please, a little bit quicker.
Oh my days. Yeah, and it's just a mind games constantly, right? Waxet's just trying to fake out these vaults as much as possible, trying to switch it up as much as possible. Sometimes goes for the wall, sometimes doesn't. Has Kurzip second guessing himself, and that's why these whiffs are coming through. So it might look a little bit easier than it actually is for Kurzip, but it is almost a 50-50 when you're playing against such a good survivor. Another pre-drop coming down here, and I do believe it's Nightfall that has been found, and he is gonna get tapped instantly after the pre-drop. Unhook as well happening on the other side, and there we go for the people coming down from Zanami, actually.
Kurzip looking really, really confident now for the situation he faces with all the pressure on his shoulders, getting rid of the Shaq pallet here as well, chasing Feng, the final healthy survivor. You would have everyone injured if you go for the Feng here. Really, really great work. Nightfall now with the reset, so you know that the survivors are taking care of themselves and not really sitting on the objectives right here. But Feng doing an incredible job fighting back, wasting time away from the killer here. He's busy at the fun bus. You have this relatively strong pallet as well. Need to find the mind game, but Feng has the higher patience here compared to Kurzip. So very, very nice chase that is at this point taking little bit too long.
You can't go through there, unfortunately. The survivor can, actually. I don't know if Watson actually noticed it. If they did, they could definitely use that to their advantage. It's going to be a little bit of a wider loop around here for the side of Kurzip. And two gens pop right now in the distance. That means one more is all that they need on the side of Luminescence. And surely that should be doable from here on out for Luminescence Dire.
Absolutely, for making that possible on the side of Divine Dead, I do think these mid-game chases took a little bit too long. As good as Kurzip played that here, we do see leaving a generator on 70%. We do have a pop goes to Weasel Kick, so that's going to come in, but you do I always love when that's coming through. But we do see the regression coming in now, but that's not going to be too much of a threat to the survivors. I do hope they are going for the reset here on two survivors. Taking so much risk with injured survivors would be a little bit too hard, but unfortunately not getting the down here onto Nightfall, who just got caught out using the firecracker as well. Really, really beautiful, making the distance that is needed to reach the next pallet. And yeah, Kurzip doesn't have time for these chases, needs to take care of the gents.
Yeah, exactly. You can see Nightfall even pre-dropping another pallet, trying to say, no, keep being on me, keep being on me. I'm a juicy target, I swear. But yeah, Kurzip not having it knows that he needs to go around and try to find these generators, because Sasua hasn't been healing at any point. Zanami is the only one who actually has, so he is good to go. He's good to stick on a gen for as long as possible until Kurzip is almost there to hit him. And this generator is actually still regressing, so might be a little bit of an issue here for Kurzip, trying to figure out where Zanami actually is, because there's no eruption on the other side of the map. When Sasua, who goes down over here, is probably completely fine with it, and especially if there's a deliverance on Sasua coming up.
If this would be deliverance, that would be really, really difficult. I think I've noticed a broken status effect earlier, but that was something else that's going to be
for the people. Sasua,
yeah. True. You're wrong. And that's going to be now so much pressure being lost for the killer. You don't need anyone coming over towards the unhook. You don't even need anyone for the reset, because Sasua is going to be broken for a little bit. So they are just going to sit on the generators, potentially doubling up in the distance there. And everything Kurzip has to do is basically going cross map left and right, but that's not how you're able to win the game and put the pressure onto the survivor team. You're checking on this generator once again, nobody here, instead catching one of the injured survivors in the open. That's going to be Nightfall again, but he still has a pallet left to defend himself, so even this chase is going to take a little bit longer. Going for this one though, a very important hook and a very important pop kick as well. I can just hope, if you're a fan of Divine Dead, that this is still enough time.
Yeah, exactly. And we need to check on some of the generators. Where has Zanami been here? If we can flick through a little bit, I need to see what the progressions are looking like, because I feel like someone is about to pop a generator at some point here in the next couple of seconds. We do see this one at around like 90%, I feel like. That was insanely close. Maybe 10 seconds more and that would have definitely been the one to pop here. Sasua still, however, injured, so we can only expect him to actually be on that side of the map. And there it is, the fourth generator being popped. And yeah, Dire, this is just GG's for Luminescence. They do get the first set win on the Blight here, and just got to hand it to them. They played it super, super well here in the early game to give them this.
And there you can see that it's not necessarily a killer playing bad or making mistakes, right? We just saw the power of a very coordinated survivor team. There was the unhook with the injured survivor, and I was just about to say you need to be very careful here because potentially you don't get the unhook and then you're slugged on the ground. But he had to go all the way towards the other side to prevent the survivor from the generator and didn't make it just by a couple of seconds. Last generator now coming out as well. Very, very impressive play here by Luminescence. Jake able to dodge this hit here, knowing probably going over to go for Sasura. That's going to be a hit on the Shaq here into the back. And I do think we should at least see one survivor leaving the Blood Lodge here.
Yeah, we should at least see one person escaping, maybe even two. I think Nightfall is going to be the sacrificial lamb, probably. I don't believe Cursive can make it over to the other side, at least not continuously. At some point, someone is going to escape. So he's just going to be content with this hook onto Nightfall in the back, of course, just to make sure that no one can come and save. But I believe Sasura and Zanami are going to get out, and it hurts for Divine Dead, obviously, but honestly, extremely well played by Luminescence in the early game, and that's what is giving them this two-man escape at the end of the day. And this just means the next trial is gonna be even more deadly for Divine Dead.
Divine Dead has to pull out what everyone kinda expects and what Divine Dead is known for. Their Huntress has always been a very threatening and very impressive killer. So the difficulty is you now have to perform like that under pressure, because the first set point is going to Luminescence with a beautiful score of 43-23. Very, very great work there, almost doubling the score of the opponent. If Divine Dead is able to pull their perfect Huntress performance in set number two to push us into the tiebreaker, or if Luminescence is going to take it with a 2-0, is what you're going to find out right after a short break.
Welcome back to DBDLeague. We got Divine Dead on Killer Undead, having the Huntress in his grasp, trying to pilot this killer as best as possible to prove that they are indeed better than Luminescence. As of right now, Luminescence took the first game, but a strong start coming in here from Undead onto Sasuha. Doesn't get the second hatchet down though. Can he get the third one to land? Firecracker's going in, but not going to do anything at all. And the third hatchet, not going to land either. So maybe we got some comp corner gaming instead. And this is going to be hard for the Huntress because he is a 110, does get the M1 in the end, though.
Yeah, if you see a survivor in the open, in the dead end, you have two choices, right? If you do go for the hatchet and don't just run after them holding W, then this hatchet needs to hit. Otherwise, these 3-4 seconds can make a difference in the end. That's going to be the first stack of Scorchuk Pain Resonance. Interesting for me, this Infectious Fright to get additional information is an interesting one, right? Because your Terror Radius on Huntress is a little bit reduced. So the information you are given is only potentially valuable for being around the shack if someone is going to hide in the pallet or the doorway. But we see something like Agitation usually. But Infectious Fright, really interesting perk. I can't wait to see the value coming out here. Divine Dead will very likely have a good strategy on it if they are going to pick this corner perk. And now we are going to see if that's going to be a survivor moving in. I thought I spotted someone in the distance, but I was wrong. They just sacrificed a teammate here into the second stage. But the generator progress, on the other hand, doesn't look too confident so far.
No, we did see one being at around the 80-90 part, but Sasuha is definitely going to go to stage two. Another thing that's also interesting, you did point out the Infectious Fright, but we also have the Noed coming in from Undead. I know that some Huntress is really, really swear by this, but obviously it's going to be more of a try to make a play in the end. Beautiful hitbox hit here onto Nightfall. It might have looked like it wasn't supposed to, but that is how the hitbox works. It is like a cylinder around the survivor and not so much just a line straight up from where the model is. We do see the unhook coming in from Tsunami. He probably has the deliverance once again, and that's why he was actually the one to go for it. Nightfall or Sasuha is the one getting chased here. I can't really tell. I think it is Sasuha, Dire.
I do think so as well. We do see the vault coming out right here. Bamboozle would be another.
Oh!
Onto the Huntress, and that's going to be the head-on stun from the other locker. Very, very great. They're cutting out a few additional seconds from the killer. We do see a very nice one onto the back of Tsunami as well. Three survivors injured now, an unusual condition on the Huntress set. A relatively weak killer struggling, and now we do see Infectious Raid. Fried coming a little bit into clutch here. You do know exactly where the aces can go onto him. Unfortunately, missing the hatchets here, but that's now going to be a very risky condition for our team. They need to stay alive.
They definitely do, and Tsunami needs to make this worth his while, but no, it doesn't happen, and he's gonna go down from the last hatchet. The question is, was he actually expecting someone to be in that locker, or was it just a reload? It's kind of a 50-50, and I'm sure Undead will say that, no, I thought someone was nearby, and that was why I was going for it, but Sasura is going to be sacrificed here. Tsunami is going to go onto the hook here in a second. We don't have Eruption. We do not have Pop Goes the Weasel. We have a Pain Rest hook probably and possibly going onto Tsunami. If that's going to be the case, it's going to be a little bit extra time that they're at the very least going to quench out of this Huntress. But is Waxits on a gen that is far progress? We only saw about the 60% from Nightfall, so this is not looking too great here for the side of Luminescence, actually.
That's now going to be the next fresh hook here as well. So the generator regression just kicking in one more time. We do see a good progress on one generator. That's the thing. We've seen that in the early game already. This spread with multiple survivors across the objectives doesn't happen. And now it's going to be even more difficult to enforce that ever again, because we do have an elimination already. We do see that a beautiful three gen on the other side of the Wreckers Yard would be available as well, but our killer, just staying close, wants to enforce the second hook stage onto this survivor. A crow has been disturbed in the back, could be a survivor that is moving in, but Undead instead going over here. Lori getting another generator done, that's going to be 2 points, and Oxlade's going to come in here, rotating for the unhook, unexpected by the killer, I believe, but you cannot risk too much here, especially as the last healthy survivor.
Yeah, definitely. And I don't know if Tsunami obviously doesn't have Deliverance because it is a Huntress, so that's not allowed. I don't know what I was thinking of earlier, but that was what I was kind of... We had so many Tier 1 killers today that I just expect Deliverance to be here every single time when someone goes for the unhook very aggressively. Waxets, however, is going to be found out here, and this is going to land. If you vault against a Huntress, it's almost always a death sentence unless you have to distance for it. No hit coming in here, three hatchets remaining, and I feel like Tsunami needs to be unhooked here. And we do see the crossover coming in from Nightfall. He is going to be able to get the unhook. Is he, however, going to trade, though? Here, the endurance hit goes in onto Tsunami. He is ripe for the taking, but only one hatchet left. If this one misses, that's going to be Tsunami in the clear, but nope. Tsunami is going to go down, and that is the second kill going through here for Undead and Divine Dead. And they must feel some momentum shifting now.
Absolutely, yeah. Two generators still standing on two eliminations already coming through is a really, really insane result for the killers so far. Divine Dead really, really showing off. We put a little bit of pressure onto them by highlighting the Huntress performance so much, but they are proving why we did it! No! That was a very, very beautiful one, and that is leaving VLC Nightfall is the final standing survivor, also injured, so you won't even have a difficult time to spot that survivor. And I do think I just saw the lorry leaving in the distance. The scratch marks should still be around. They were trying to go for the fourth generator, but they are now on the tail of that survivor, unbreakable, not available in this match against the Huntress. So that should be the 4K coming out with two gens standing. I think that is by far the best Huntress performance we've seen in DBDLeague in a long shot.
Yeah, definitely giving some challenge to Xeno's earlier Huntress performance. Beautifully played here by Undead. Honestly, getting the 4K at two gens left still. Super, super impressive performance. And this is exactly why Divine Dead, they picked the Huntress. So now the question just becomes, can Luminescence actually compete against the 4K2? What are your thoughts, Dire?
Oh, Luminescense can definitely compete with Divine Dead against difficult situations, and Luminescense has proven in the past that they can play against the odds and still pull something. I have to be honest though, I don't think they are strong enough to counter this, because Divine Dead can even ignore a 3 gen now, and usually we are talking about win conditions like that when we are having a Spirit, a Blight, or a Nurse, but not a Huntress. And getting 4 generators done against a Huntress is usually what we see by a lot of comp teams. And as much as Luminescense can fight, I don't want to be too negative, but I realistically don't see them doing that, especially because the survivor team of Divine Dead is moving in or coming into the next trial with such wide shoulders and literally smiling faces.
Oh, for sure. And you gotta just give it to Divine Dead. After that performance that they had on Survivor, they played super well, do not get me wrong, but it was a difficult, difficult task for them to try to win that game. But coming out swinging like this, Undead, showing his team that, hey, we can win this set of games, we can make it to the playoffs still, and getting the 4K2, unbelievable performance by him, honestly.
Absolutely, yeah. Divine Dead is going to take all that confidence onto the shoulders of their survivors. Luminescense needs to take the little break here we have to set up trial number 4 to sort themselves, get a little bit of plan, maybe an unexpected perk or something like that, onto their killer player. Whoever is coming out in trial 4 has the pressure. We'll find out how Luminescense is performing on the killer side after a short break. To all the professional tunnelers in FaZe Campus, watch closely because this is competitive Dead by Daylight and everyone in here is a specialist in doing exactly that. And we do see Yokarex now on the Huntress here for Luminescense. There's a, for me, 99% confirmed tiebreaker, because with the performance Divine Dad has shown us in the previous trial and putting a 28-6 just needing 4 generators here, it is going to be a very, very tough challenge. But we talked about it, Luminescense has proven in the past they can perform against the odds, they can pull something crazy when nobody expects them to be successful. So I would be happy to be surprised and proven wrong here.
Oh, definitely, me too. And like you said, the odds are definitely stacked against Yokad. He does, however, find a survivor pretty early on here. Question is if he can do anything with it. This tile is not the best for Huntress, however. It's really, really difficult to get any flick shots in here. Kind of just need to hold forward and try to maybe give them one. Yep, just like that. Beautifully done here. Tree Trick now in a heap of trouble, though. If he goes down here, it's not going to be super good. And yep, that is the first pain res stack that's going to come through. And we do see a little bit more of a conventional build here, outside of maybe, I'd say, the brutal strength coming out. We do have the Agi, the pain res, and the corrupt, obviously.
Yeah, the agitation, one of these standard perks or the core perks for Huntress on the Wrecker's Yard. You really want that basement. It's going to be more difficult to rescue from there. This first hatchet onto the rescuing team is not going to hit, and we do see Tree Trick facing the common situation here. When going down early, the killer does want to eliminate you as quick as possible. So Tree Trick hopefully able to stay a little bit longer alive, but that's not going to happen. A beautiful shot coming out by Yokadex here, finishing it off very quickly. Boom, back onto the hook. That's the second stage, almost immediately into the game here. And Divine Dead with the aim of 4 generators, with losing a survivor so early, that could be tough.
Yeah, definitely could. And this brutal strength is starting to make a little bit more sense to me. You know, he needs to get the ball rolling early, so he doesn't want to play around these pallets at all. That's probably why he wants to take the more aggressive path here and try to get the brutal strength in, just delete these pallets as fast as possible, so it's not a gimp here for him at in any circumstance. So maybe he can just get the first K already out of here at 5 or 4 gens. That would be absolutely huge for Yokad and Luminescense. The first gen does get done here. Now it's all about trying to figure out if you want to camp this one out or if you want to actually go and try to find a new survivor. And Dire, I feel like the best choice is just to sit around this hook now.
Now we do see them trying to go for the generators here. 2 of them done. Tree Trick going to die. Gens before friends, but I feel like Divine Dead needs a little bit more on their survivor side here. Usually you want to see three generators being completed in exchange for one of the teammates being gone entirely. It's now going to be the kick onto the generator right here. We don't spot any survivor. 10% on this generator, and that's it, Nico. That doesn't look like smashing four generators and taking the win to me.
Doesn't look like it so far, at the very least. They're having issues right now. They're not really certain on what to do. We need to look around a little bit on the other survivors as well, see if anyone is actually on a generator, if any progress is being made. And no, everyone's just doing hide-and-seek shenanigans right now. Ada, the Curzup, trying to get back onto the generator, provide a little bit of pressure over there. They just need two more generators, Dire, but it's not looking too hot for them right now. They're looking a little bit trembling, actually.
Yeah, it looks tough, right? Because the confidence from the previous trial seems to shatter a little bit with the losing tree trick so early here. Yokard X, with all the pressure and dominance he's currently showing here in his Huntress game, seems to throw off Divine Dead a little bit. That was a very beautiful patience game there as well. And if this is going to hit, then I'm going to fall off.
Oh!
Yeah, this is exactly what you need when you want to take a win condition away from a team. And Divine Dead now, two generators need to be done, but you have a hooked survivor in basement now, and we have seen not that much progress on the gens either, so they are under a lot of trouble and in a big pressure situation now.
They definitely are. I do feel like the pain rest might have been the better play, though, because you're trying to play for the win here. You definitely don't want to go into a tie condition. That just means you have to play the Huntress again, unless you're extremely confident that you can just take that rematch and to provide better survivor gameplay against the Huntress this time around. But, oh, I don't know, Dire. I feel like it should have been a pain rest stack instead of the basement one. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have to agree. Yeah, if you bring this back, because right, especially as the Huntress, we've seen the tunnel out strategy, so you only get one stack there. And if you now have the second survivor in the basement potentially trying to protect that, you won't get that many chances to get the value out of the perk. Or our killer feels like he doesn't need it because he's quick enough to get these downs themselves. But I have to agree, it would have been a great one. Nice dodge here by Manox with the crouch tag here. Now into the TNL with the mind games. Is it going to work out for him? Oh, that's a yes. Just holding W can sometimes throw the killer off as well, because they would expect that you are going to dodge something. This survivor here going down in the pallet, trying to waste time almost. And we do see them sitting on the generator right there, but left in time. So Manox slug there in the pallet. Yukarex needs to make a crucial decision here, though. Who can you chase, and when do you need to return to the gens? And I feel like the time to go all the way back and hook the survivor is just not there, so you need to try work with a double slug.
Yeah, definitely is the case. I mean, you just need to hold on to this and try to 4K from this position, but it just seems so difficult on a killer like Huntress. I mean, you don't have the map coverage that you need, as if you were playing a Blight, for example. If he was in this scenario, he would be joyful right now, but this is not the same type of tier of killer that we're talking about, Dire. This is, however, a Huntress that can... Oh my lord, that was so close. A free injury actually coming through onto Cursive. Yokap needs to count his lucky stars for that one.
Problems team with that injury being applied now as well. Good news, though, that Yokap X doesn't have the time to chase this, because he needs to go all the way cross map and check on the final generator, because if the fourth one would come through, that would be the win for Divine Dead here, and us going into the tiebreaker set. We do see the rescue in the distance and trying to go for a longer snipe, but that's not going to work out here. Our survivor going towards the outside of the Wrecker's Yard and doing a good job here by dodging the hatchet twice. All of them need to be very careful now, as they are all injured, but that one is going to hit God Khan straight over the pallet, so that's going to be hooked stage number six. But I still feel like Divine Dead can pull it if they are having one more very brilliant chase.
Oh, definitely. And we do see the pain res coming in here, probably, and going to be explosion here on the left side, I think, right on that gen. Yep, that is the case. And yeah, again, my mind just goes back to that basement hook that he went for. I really feel like that should have been a Scorch Hook Pain Rest play instead, if he wanted to try to get the win out of this game instantly. Maybe didn't expect him to have as much gen progression as they did, but I feel like that was a misplay on Yokout's part. part, unfortunately, and maybe he's gonna pay for it now and maybe lose the game instead of just getting a tie. But I'm not sure which I'm not sure what they would rather prefer, to go just into the next set with the Deathslinger, or if they want to retry the Huntress once again, Dire.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult, right? Because both teams are in a situation right now where you kind of need a plan B for Divine Dead. It didn't work out to apply the efficiency across the generators and the objectives, so they need to change their approach a little bit. But YokaiX is also not in a position where you can be the most confident, because you're just one objective away from losing this set point here. So both teams are on edge and need to find something that is going to turn this game potentially. That was a very beautiful patient shot onto Killsep. Immediately we see the rescue onto Manox though, so it's such a back and forth here between the teams. We do have another stack of the pain rest and a fresh hook. Good news for the survivors, however, that's 2 minutes of hang time, but they have to make the tough decision if they want to heal or if they're going for the next generator. And right now, I don't know what is actually the better one.
Yeah, it depends on the gen progressions, obviously. If you only have about 20% on one of them because of that pain rest stack, I guess maybe you just go for the heal, try to reset, try to figure out if you can maybe get the unhook or get some pressure over here instead. So really decent gen spread they actually have. And they do go for the unhook, actually, and not even a reset. Can they get it onto Curcep, though? That is the main question, because that generator that is far, far away from this unhook, that one needs to be completed. And this is a problem here. Yeah, Manox is just going to go down. There's nothing he can do about that at all.
Got Khan and Kilsep are now carrying the responsibility here for the final generator. Right now it would be a tie, so we would replay the Huntress set on the Wrecker's Yard. We do need a winner in DBD League before we are moving forward, so let's see what's going to happen here. Next generator going to be investigated by our killer checked, but there's not that much of progress yet. We might still see a little bit of a kick here, but yeah, that's roughly 30-40% right here. So the killer doesn't need to worry too much yet. The survivors have to worry even further, because especially when they lose another teammate, that's going to be rough. And they double up this one generator here, understandable, because you want to get the progress in, but both injured at the same time is also a lot of risk being taken.
It definitely is, and question is if it's gonna pay off or not. We do have two gens being extremely far away from each other, obviously, so they need to call out real good and real early here for the Huntress to not be able to get anything going. And this pallet is just gonna be pre-dropped earlier than anything else in the world, and getting a good distance here. That generator is about, I would say, 70-80%. And meanwhile, the other one up north, I feel like, should be progressed really good at this point as well. And good jukes here by Menox, actually. If he can juke like three more hatchets, he would be in a really, really good spot. And here, the tires also giving him a little bit of a protection. He is going to take the M1, however, was expecting a respect play coming out here from Yokad, and that generator just isn't far enough progressed, so it looks like it might just be the tie condition coming through, actually, which is all said and done pretty decent from Luminescense, and that must mean they really want to prove that they can do better against the Huntress as the survivors, because that seems to be what they're playing for. But this generator is actually getting there. It's about 70% right now, Dire.
Very, very rough situation for Divine Dead and for Luminescense as well. That would be the set point towards the tiebreaker, the 1-1 being ensured in trial number 4. Will they get it? That's going to be the question here. That's going to be the answer. Yes, they will. Divine Dead forcing us towards the Deathslinger to bring the situation in here. Very, very well played. Not as confident as the killer game of Divine Dead, that's for sure. Here, a lot more struggle on the end, but still going or proved that they do have everything that is necessary here to take the 1-1. And that's going to be the confidence game now, right? If you would get the final generator and take the outs, I feel like that would be very, very good for our team here.
Oh, definitely. Can I just say, that was a beautiful shot. That's not an easy one to make. Like, the hitboxes on this map can be pretty wonky with the rocks and the trees in the way, but super, super good job here by Yokaden, showing that he is no stranger to Huntress, but this the odds were just stacked against him from the beginning, honestly. I mean, Undead getting the result that he got, it was just going to be hard from the get-go.
Now, yeah, the question is how they're going to deal with that on the side of Luminescense, right? Because they were quite close. They were, yeah, able to pull it, basically. But the problem is that now it's going to fade away. Divine Dead has just taken it, so a little bit of frustration maybe coming in. So you need to also do something for your mindset in the next upcoming break here, and be sure that you are going into a very confident Deathslinger set. We do see that Kirsup is actually putting up a little bit of juke and juicing here, now going to take the M1 and running away. Manox potentially having time to repair that final generator. So Divine Dead towards the end now with two survivors, looking stronger than with four.
It definitely is, but that seems to be the case today for every team almost. It's almost as if when they lose a survivor, they play safer and they play more, what should I say, they think about their decisions more than they do when they are four survivors. They kind of just go with the flow at that point, it seems like. But having a plan from the get-go is super, super important when you're playing comp DBD. Obviously, tunneling is also very important. We all know that. Camping too, tactical positioning, whatever you want to call it. But having a plan as to survivors is almost the most important thing you can have when getting into a game. Calling out these generators that you're going to work on, calling out the killer's positioning at all times, is just alpha and omega when you get into these games.
And we see once again the snipe attempt. I was thinking there for a second, but now going to just go back to the generator, taking care of the last percentages here, because you want to keep the result as close together as possible, especially if it just be 2 points. You can say, okay, we lost this second set, but it was just one generator, so Divine Dead couldn't prove they're dominating or they are in a controlling spot here. So you can just check out what is going to be possible for you. We do see that Ace is doing a lot of good hiding here. Cursep walking around with the Urban Evasion, an absolute pro in stealthing here as well. And slowly but slowly, they are coming these percentages into the generators, and Yokarex is not able to spot anyone for a good next chase.
Yeah, not until he gets to see some scratch marks or something at the very least. We have the Iron Will as well, so it's gonna be very, very difficult to actually find these survivors. I think I thought I saw the head of Huntress over the wall, and I think Yokai is also a little bit surprised as to why he can't find these pesky survivors. All the generators are regressing at the moment, though, so they need to make a play at some point, obviously, and at that point is where Yokai is going to find the third and fourth survivor, more than likely. Right now, just playing for a little bit of morale boost for his survivors to make sure that they can get into the next game really, really fired up and try to prove that they are the better team. But honestly, it's looking pretty rough for him to do anything but get a 4k1 here. I mean, it's impossible, obviously, but he doesn't want to let them escape at the very least, that's for sure.
Yeah, not allowing the escape. Is there going to be another read on the lock? It is, but Head-On is coming in as a defense mechanism. Manox not allowing the immediate down, but has to take at least the injury as a punishment. Patience game around the pallet here. Looks good for our survivor, but then eventually going to be down. So the next elimination coming through, and you now also know where that final survivor is. So it is going to finish off here with a 4k as well. At least I'm just going to assume that, because we are in chase now with the final survivor. Both Huntresses, though, that's what we can say, compared to all other Huntress matches, have been absolutely great.
They have been absolutely explosive, coming straight out of the game. Okay, that's... I think Kurzov knows when the time is up, and the jig is up as well. So he's just having a little bit of fun. Once again, these two teams seem to enjoy playing against each other. They know that it's all banter at the end of the day. Honestly, when the game is over, it's over, and they didn't want to prolong it any longer. I can respect that for sure. And yeah, honestly, super, super good play coming out of Undead, or sorry, coming out of Divine Dead this time around.
Divine Dead doing a wonderful job here on the survivor side as well as in the previous killer game. Luminescense did a good job as well. Yukarexia, absolutely impressive performance on this one. Are we going to see a little bit of hatch giving here? That's going to be the question. Yeah. Are we giving it away? That would at least be a plus rep on the Steam profile afterwards. We do see the survivor being a little bit skeptic, not believing it yet. And we do see him now going towards the hatch, just 5 meters, 4.5, making it closer and closer. But oh no, it's going to be the troll by the killer. That's an F on the profile here, and that's going to be the elimination. Wonderful, 36 to 34, pushing us towards the slinger. And now I do think my prediction is becoming reality. Divine Dad is going to take it.
Yeah, that might be the case. We have to wait and see what is actually going to be the case on the Slinger. Obviously, a very, very volatile killer here. Needs to get going from the get-go. Get a bunch of early injuries with the cigar, if possible. But we just have to wait until after this small break to see who is going to take the next game here between Luminescense and Divine Dead. Welcome back to the tiebreaker, ladies and gentlemen. Everything in between. Yokat is now taking on the Deathslinger against Divine Dead. And obviously, we saw dominant performance by Undead earlier on with the Huntress. And already right here, we do actually see one shot going through him with the cigar. That's going to be a quick reload and quick stun going over. And the tree trick might be the first casualty. I feel like this is something we have seen before. Can he make it around this corner? He needs to do the lunge, and he does! Beautifully executed by Yokat.
Not joking around at all here. Wow, that was a really, really fast down, exactly how you need it. And potentially, that is the result of just keeping the score one generator apart in the previous trial. You have proven that you can keep Divine Dead under control, that you are the dominant character playing here on the Wrecker's Yard. And that's exactly how it looks here. Beautiful down, beautiful pressure. We do see Divine Dead just starting on the generators here.
Yeah, we definitely do, and the Corrupt Intervention also being lifted. No pain risk being used, by the way, on Tree Trick. He just wants the pressure to keep mounting right now. He also has the Sloppy Butcher, so when the unhook does happen, that's going to take a while for them to actually get the healing done onto Tree Trick. And the question is if he wants to get the second stage here, or if he wants to try to find a new one. He's looking for Godcon at the moment, it seems like. He's the only one lurking around trying to get this unhook happen.
Yeah, lurking for the unhook also means that there's no efficiency being poured into the objectives by one survivor at this point. Serena is the one staying close here, and she is a little bit too far, and the killer won't allow it. So it's very likely going to be the camp into the second stage with Godcon not providing anything for the team in terms of the generators, at least. And we might actually spot them out. Yukarex, though, does realize now that Serena was close. A beautiful shot once again. Next injury being taken. Now you can rotate back towards the hook, and that's the decision our killer is going to take, expecting that the next survivor would rotate in. Two generators are sacrificed, though, for this second stage camp. But if Tree Trick is going to die here, I feel like Yukarex can be happy with what he achieved so far.
Oh, definitely. If he gets one kill at three gens, that is absolutely beautiful. But we do see, actually, the unhook happening here. And now he's just going to stay close to Tree Trick until the endurance effect is over. And it is going to run out just about now. Can he get the lunge over this? I don't believe he can. No, the fun bust is just a little bit too big here for Tree Trick, or sorry, for Yokat to actually deal with. And Tree Trick does have a good check spot here, does see the vault coming through, and I don't believe he should go for this. He's probably just gonna get hit over this. Yep, that's the second down, but it is going to be the kill onto Tree Trick right now.
The down onto Tree Trick coming through. That's the third stage, and that also means that Tree Trick is going to stay bye. And we are going to say now that Divine Dead, once again in this position, you don't want to be in, losing your teammate too early into the trial. Just two generators. Usually, you want to have three generators done when you lose your first teammate, especially against a weaker killer like the Slinger. But let's see how quick it will be possible to go into the next chase. Well, there we have the answer, Nico.
Yep, straight away we see him onto Menox. This around an LT wall, which is not the best thing you can have for Slinger. He wants the open areas, obviously. He wants the easy vault shots to come through. But, oh, nice. Nice little power stun coming in, actually. I wasn't even expecting him to sit around that corner. He is going to, however, take the runaway. Is he going to get enough distance to get into Shaq? That is the difference. Nope, he's not. He's actually going to get chained up instantly and using the car to get the stun off with the cigar once again. And we did see the pain res also coming through. Very, very important onto Tree Trick. That meant 25% off of the biggest, or sorry, the highest generator. And that means it's a little bit more difficult here for the side of Divine Dead to get more gens done. And with the healing coming in as well onto Menox, it's not looking too good right now for Divine Dead, Dire.
Yeah, Divine Dead is... It's my personal taste, though. I don't claim that to be the truth, but for my personal taste, Divine Dead is staying a little bit too long, too injured, and taking too many risks. When we are talking about going for unhooks, when we're talking about not healing each other, or when we are talking about like being in a little bit of difficult positions where the killer has an easier time chasing you. We now see the 4.4 killer struggling to get around, but then you just go for the weapon. And that was a beautiful quick shot onto Cursip as well here. Next down coming through. Now the fourth stage took a little bit, but we don't see a generator in exchange yet. So that's going to be the good news for Luminescence here. Still feel like that YokaLex is playing a dominant part here. We do see 60 and 50 on two generators across the map, but that's not going to be enough to put serious pressure up.
Definitely is not going to be enough as of just yet. And even better news is the fact that he actually had a pain res right next to where the down was. So that's even bigger issues here for Divine Dead. Is he going to camp this out, however, or is he going to try to find someone? He knows that someone was lingering around that generator. And beautiful play here by GoodCon, actually, making sure that he is not spotted just by using a measly little tree in his way. And the unhook could very well happen here sooner than later. We also are probably going to see the third gen pop on the other side of the map. Menox has been working hard to get that one popping.
50% on one objective here. Two more points would be so, so good. There is the other generator, so we might see four coming out. Cursip 50 seconds away from the elimination now, and I don't think that's going to be the strategy here. Yeah, you don't want to wait for that. You just take the second stage and then you're checking on the generators here. Good read that they are on the fun bus. And GoodCon leaving early though, not allowing any additional injury. And that's important now because Menox will have a hard time doing anything for the teammate here. The even worse news is that there's no generator all the way on the other side anymore. So yeah, that's going to be the rough thing. They need to heal at some point.
Definitely need to heal Menox up at some point, unless they just want to play for the 4k1 instead. I don't believe that's the best choice that they have. I mean, you gotta believe that GoodCon is gonna try to go for the unhook right here, right now, because there's no other time to really go for it. No, that's not even gonna be the case. They're actually just gonna let Cursip get sacrificed, and I don't know if this is the correct call to go for a Dire, because if Yokad actually manages to stop GoodCon from doing that gen over at the bus, that is the only generator that they actually have progress on, if I'm not mistaken. If that one doesn't get done, it's going to be big, big, big issues. And yeah, right here, he actually sees GoodCon. He's trying to go for a pot shot here between the buses. Is that going to be the case? He does actually get it, and the cigar is going to come in. Clutch here, and it's not even needed. He's actually just going to keep him right here as long as possible. Should maybe go over and kick that gem to make sure it's not getting done. But no, he wants the down as fast as possible. He wants to get the pain rest stack instead. Menox might be on the generator meanwhile, so he needs to make this as fast as possible. He's going to get the down. He's going to go back to the generator again. Dire, I feel like, can he make it in time? I don't think so.
I don't think so either. That should going to work out. We hear the progress. Yeah, that's going to be the fourth generator. So this is important, right? Because then at least you are forcing them to break a 3-gen, even though Bracket's Yard is a little bit rough with 3-genning. for the killer, but at least you forced them to get all generators done. However, no one escapes death, no way out for your killer, because all generators would be enough. A click and a dodge from Manox into the celebration. They're very, very well deserved, making Yokadex a little bit struggling. And once again, that making is now going work. To be, yeah, the juice here.
Making him work for it 100%. And can he actually get the shot off here? A little bit of moonwalking with the flashlight saving as well. He's having fun with it. He knows that he's, it's just a matter of time before he goes down. There's not another generator to be popped either. But yeah. beautiful play coming out of Menach. Where was all of this earlier in the game? This is what they needed earlier.
Right, this is what they needed before, in the early game, when Tree Trick was in chase. Why is it happening right now? Finally, we do. Yeah, now the nodding is still a little bit late, though. But yeah, Menox now finally going down. That's going to be the 4K confirmed on one remaining generator. And we do see the frustration being very clear here about this last chase.
Yeah, he definitely needed to end that chase a little bit earlier, or go back and kick the gen and try to work it out in some other way. Wasn't the case, though, unfortunately. So 4K1 is what he has to be happy about. Not sure if he actually is, but it does mean that they need to clear all the gens on the side of Luminescence survivors. And that is a tall task to ask, I feel like, honestly.
Tall task indeed, because against a Deathslinger, same as the Huntress, we also expect a few outs being taken. A 28-8 is going to come out here for Team Divine Dead, and for Luminescence 28, and for Divine Dead 8 points. You really want to see outs against a Divine... against a Divine Slinger. No, it's a Divine Slinger. You want to get all the generators done against the Divine Slinger. That's the new killer introduced with the latest DLC.
Oh, nice. I thought it was Singularity. My bad.
Yeah, right. But seeing the Huntresses and how they play, we also said about Huntress, usually we expect some escapes. And both Huntresses were actually able to 4K. So maybe both Slingers are going to do it as well, and it's just about the number of generators.
It might just come down to that, yeah. And once again, having to do 5 generators is no joke, especially when the killer knows that you're specifically just going for the 5K. So you don't... I mean, you can't just play super aggressively on the Deathslinger if that is your info. You need to try to create a 3-gen as fast as possible and try to protect that as much as possible. Survivors know this as well, obviously, so they will come prepared as well. I can't wait to see how Luminescence are going to play the game coming up here when they are taking over the Survivor side right after this break.
Welcome back, everyone. This is the final trial, except they are going for a tie. The win condition for our survivors are all generators being completed, and Tree Trick doesn't want to waste a single second here, wants to put the pressure up early, but the survivor got away with that, has the time to drop this pallet early, sacrificing the firecracker as well. So a lot of action coming out here, but it is going to be the injury. And now, because of that extra pathing over the window, that's going to end in a 2-tap here. So a dream start for Tree Trick and Divine Dead.
Definitely a dream start here for Tree Trick, that is for certain. Waxed's not even getting to use anything but a pallet and one window, and none of them actually meant anything. And we do see here the agitation with the pain res combo coming in. So you know what that means. That's going to be 25% off the most progress generator. And we already saw someone running away as well. So follow the scratch marks and we might just get a second down actually.
That is going to be really crazy if a second down would come in relatively quickly here. Let's check on the generators, though. I really like how confident Tree Trick is. We don't see this camping or this straight camping into the second stage. Instead, we see him move quite far away, making sure that he also gets a good understanding of what's going on around him. Missing the shot, though, so you can't pull up Fang to wait out the BT, but that one is going now anyway. We have seen the ace being around. That's going to be an injury onto that rescuer. And Feng trying to use these trees. And ooh, that's going to be a juke. And that was one that Tree Trick actually needed to hit, because you do want to tunnel out Feng as quick as possible.
Oh, definitely, for sure. And question is if we can get this before she gets to the window. The vault, though, coming in. I feel like that's a mistake. Oh, he's trying to get the blind off here before the hit comes through, but it is going to connect anyways. Beautiful done here by Zanami. He tried to save his teammate as much as possible. He even took a hit, but it's just not enough. Question is, if this maybe could be a blind option? No, no flashlight saving coming through this time around. And now we're going a little bit further away into the edge map just to make sure that this Fang, or Farmer, sorry, is actually going to be sacrificed this time around.
If that was going to come through very, very soon here, potentially with another two tap after the next unhook, then Divine Dead would be in a good spot. Now, this tunneling out to the second stage took way too long. Good by the ace here, did a really, really good job as the body blocker and the rescuer. We see him now working on a 30% generator. Another one is being progressed, so the generator efficiency seems all right to me. We also have VLT Nightfall being close by to take care about the potential unhook there, so kind of setting up in a perfect way here. Luminescence covering the gens, covering the unhook. I really like what they are putting up at the moment.
Yep, definitely seems to be good so far. I'm not sure if they're actually going to be able to save Waxits, though. I feel like maybe they should just be pumping out these gens and try to play for their own win condition, which is this all gen 4K win con that we were talking about. And yeah, Waxits is 100% just going to be sacrificed here to the entity. I don't think there's anything that they can do about that. So while that is going on, let's check a little bit on the generators. Nia is still around here. That means Sasuwa is not on a generator. None of them actually are sitting on a generator as of right now. And that's kind of an issue, because Tree Trick, he's dangerous right now. If he finds Anami, that's going to be another down into a pain rest.
That would exactly be the greatest plan for Tree Trick here. You really want that ace. We do see him putting up a little bit of regression onto this generator here. We need a fresh hook as well for the Scorch Hook Pain Rest. They are just progressing to other generators now while Claudette is waiting for the Stinger to leave. So three different generators are progressed at the moment, with just two more leading into the tie condition and one more being the win here. So they really, really have the grasp onto what they need to do. They really put up the pressure and the efficiency. The plan is definitely there. About the execution of this plan, I am just worried as much as you are, especially if Ace is going down next.
Yeah, I would have to imagine that the Zanami is on the far, far side of the map, as far away as he can be from the Deathslinger, to make sure that he's not going to go down or give any easy pain rest stacks over to Tree Trek. You see the pre-drop coming in here, and now it is Nightfall's time to shy. He's going to try to play around this loop here. It's not a particularly good one against the Deathslinger, because he can shoot super, super easily over everything right here. And we do see the hit going in, and that's going to be Nightfall trying to make it to the next pallet. Should be able to do so and get a little bit of distance going, but only so much he can actually do here. This is not the perfect place to be. He might just go into the corner and say, all right, fair enough, you got me, but you're far away from the generators that we're actually doing. And this is going to be the end of Nightfall.
Sometimes that is the best decision making, though, right? You go down a little bit quicker than with the pallets, but if you are going down in the right spot, that can cut so much more time than people actually think. That's going to be now the Scorch Hook Pain Rest with that fresh hook, so a very important additional regression onto the generators here. Sasuwa is the only healthy survivor for the side of Luminescence, and we do spot our ace. There he is. We were looking for him for a while now, and he does have a very, very good resource, this truck here. Even the pallet is still up, so you can potentially cut out a little bit of time here from the killer, but you need to play this really well, and you don't have space for another mistake.
Hey, definitely no entry trick, not even trying to go for a shot here. He just breaks the pallet instantly and says, you know what, I think I'm going to take my chances elsewhere. And he is going to get the down here. I feel like, yep, nothing at all Zanami can do. That is not a good tile either to play against him. And that is actually the fourth generator done. Remember, Nightfall is still on the hook. He is definitely going to second stage. There's nothing at all that Sasuke can do about that. He needs to somehow get one more generator done or just get Nightfall right here. And yeah, second stage coming through. Is he going to get shot off? Oh, he just barely gets him in time. That was milliseconds off of being a 4K right there at one gen left.
And trying to do a little bit of left and right juking here. That's going to work out. BLT Nightfall with a very clean movement. And unfortunately, the edge of the shack there in the way of Tree Trick's chain. So that's not going to be a quick down that you really, really want. A tie condition at the moment. Once again, these two teams. And I think that is the key message here and how close the skill level of these two teams is. Once again, it just comes down to the question, can they get one more gen or not?
Oh, definitely. And it's exactly as we were talking about in the campfire pregame. These teams are not as far away as they sound to be. Like, yes, it sounds like it's far away when you say the second, third place versus sixth place, but it's not the skill level that's actually the difference. It's just these minimalistic things that come down to the wire, and that's why these teams have these win rates that they have. Two survivors left. Zanami, Sasuke, can they do one more generator? They are healing right now. They are trying to get a reset in to try to see what they can do. And I'm not sure if there's a three gen looking anywhere behind Tree Trick or that is definitely quite a three gen he has going on for himself over there. And he does find Sasuke actually.
It's a interesting decision, right? To chase so far away from his 3-gen. He needs to be very confident that first, there's no progress in all of these. I mean, you check that. But second, that he does get this down onto Sasuke quick enough, because you're leaving your 3-gen completely unprotected at the moment. Patience game going to end in Sasuke's favor here, because unfortunately, Tree Trick shooting a little bit too much towards the left. Patience game number two. Interesting spot there, trying to go for the chain, going all the way around, trying to catch the survivor, but actually Sasuke not allowing it. Look at this beautiful patience. And at this point, you better go cross-match check on your gens, but...
Is he not even doing a generator? He's actually just trying to wait to see if he can get out instead, it seems like. I'm not sure if that's the correct play. I feel like they could have maybe tried to pressure a generator at the very least. You're still full health, Tsunami. But obviously that has to be a team play. That has to be a team call, obviously. Let's just try to go for the one man out at the very least.
I think it's actually valid that what he did, because he's putting down the item and picking it up to prevent crows, and he doesn't want to move around the map. And I also agree, right? I don't think that they expected Sasuke to last so long on the truck. Because what Sasuke did there with all this patience game was not normal. They couldn't predict that. So I understand that they didn't went to the generator. Why they did it now and reveal themselves, that's a different question, though. And especially why Sasuke is running right into the 3-gen. That's an interesting one now. So I'm kind of losing my grasp on the Luminescence game plan here now. But before that, I can kind of understand it. We are now with the final survivor, Ace, here, who would need to escape in order to win. Otherwise, ladies and gentlemen, we will replay the Slinger on the Wrecker's Yard.
Yeah, we definitely will. Zanami is now probably on the other side of the map, not doing too much. Maybe putting down his flashlight. Okay, no, he's actually just sitting in a locker. That's also valid. He's obviously just trying to buy as much time for his team as possible. Sasuke needs to bleed out, though. That's going to take quite a while. And I don't even think he can actually allow Sasuke to bleed out, because that would be a penalty point, wouldn't it?
That would be 1 point deducted, yeah.
Yes, that wouldn't even be enough. So he actually needs to hook Sasuke at some point. Obviously, he can just wait until the very, very last second. But I feel like this is just going to be a hide-and-seek game. Maybe looking at some lockers, and there it is! He finds Zanami!
Wow. The second locker read of the day absolutely insane. And that's going to be the tie under the condition that this Slug Survivor Satsua Slughua. We could, no, doesn't sound too good. I thought it's funny, but it actually isn't. When I said it, I realized it's not that funny. But I tried anyway. We are on delay. Maybe we can cut this out. But this is Slinger now just guarding the area. And there he is. Yeah, that's going to be the tie between Luminescence and Divine Dead in trial number 6. We can see how close these teams are. We can see how important the match is to reach the playoffs here for both of these teams. They're not giving up. We will play the Slinger again. We are staying on the Riker's Yard. We are going to play it in alternating order now. So basically it's going to be Tree Trick straight again on the Slinger and Luminescence once again on the Survivor team. So yeah, that was an interesting one and definitely a great performance by Tree Trick here, especially after the early down. It looked like Luminescence is kind of coming back, but it wasn't enough eventually. So ladies and gentlemen, let's go into trial number 7 to figure out who's going to be the winner, and we'll be back for you straight after a short break.
Welcome back, everybody. We are not done yet for today. We had a tie last game. That means Tree Trick is once again pulling out the Deathslinger, trying to make sure that Divine Dead, when they go into next set, when they are playing Survivors, have an easier time than the 4K1 gen that was the win con, 4K0 gens that was the win con last round. And Dire, it's going to be tough to get anything better than that, because that is honestly a really, really impressive result for a Deathslinger. So I feel like it's going to be super, super tough.
Absolutely, yeah. And Tree Trick just slaughtered Luminescence Survivors, and it seems like that's going to happen again. VLT Nightfall, 40 seconds, taking first entry, running to the outside of the map, this time far away from the active generator. So, knew it when he was going around. Give him everything. But when he looked a little bit like the curve around the lockers, I knew that head on is going to happen. I'm so glad it did, because I love these cheeky plays by the Survivors. But Tree Trick now needing a little bit longer already. So Luminescence definitely with a better start here.
Definitely with a better start here. Can he get a down, however, here onto Yokat? He's just going to keep aiming at him and make sure that he doesn't get any distance away. And that is going to be the first down coming in. But surely a generator is about to pop on the other side of the map at some point. Maybe in the next 10 to 20 seconds, I feel like, there.
Should. It definitely should, because the long time they're taking, I was just about to say, it tells me that they are individually splitting the generators, but actually it is two of them working on one generator, but we should see two of them coming out. Tree Trick needs a very good game sense now to read what generator they are in, but he wants to disturb the two survivors that work together, also to find the survivor that is potentially rotating in to go for the save onto Yokar X. Finds one survivor over here. I think that means that a second survivor is already in his back, going for the unhook. Mind game's not working out, and Tree Trick's aiming rate is definitely lower than in the previous trial. You can really see that Luminescence is playing far more confident and far better in this next trial here.
Yeah, it definitely seems as if they're playing a lot more confident, or Tree Trick has lost a little bit of confidence. Not sure which one it is. I mean, he was so on point last trial, but now just missing a little bit too much. And it does seem like they're not even going for the unhook, actually. They're completely content just trying to push out these generators as much as possible and try to get maybe a three-man out and letting Yokat sit on the gen. Yokat obviously also the Slinger player, so maybe saying, hey, guys, if you guys get all the gens done, I will promise you I won't let it happen in my trial. Therefore, just try to pump those gens instead.
Pumping the gens seems to be a little bit more of a strategy from Luminescence now, but after the two generators in the early game, we haven't heard anything from the Survivor team anymore. Tree Trick is putting up the hook stages. They have to go for it. Now we do see the beautiful For the People play. So Yokar X a little bit protected here by his teammate, but already back onto that survivor. Tunneling this survivor out will take for sure a little bit longer now, but for the fact that Luminescence has the better grasp and the better position in this seventh trial of this best of three, I feel like the result in forms of generator is still not really there.
it's not there at all, obviously. We do have three people injured, as well as, you know, Zanami using the four to people, and he is going to go down here. There's nothing at all that he can do about that. That is for sure going to be a new fresh hook, and hopefully a pain risk coming through this time around, because he definitely needs it if he wants to try to keep a little bit of pressure going on onto the survivors. And is there even a three gen to be had anywhere? Because that's kind of what he's hoping for as of right now.
That's indeed what is going to happen. We do see now the fresh hook coming through. That's going to be some very valuable regression for Tree Trick and Divine Dead. Nightfall now with the hell healing as well. I really like that, because Luminescence is playing this classical non-risky approach. You do go for a lot of heals, you do take the resets whenever possible, not trying to pressure anything while being in danger. I really like that approach, and so far it definitely pays out. Fourth generator very likely going to be repaired as well. This chain break with the cigar is going to lead into the next injury, but this survivor, if being downed relatively quickly, still being a good resource for Tree Trick here.
Oh, definitely is, and Sasuke is making sure to run places where they already have gen stun. Beautiful power stun coming through here. He's not going to give him the easy shot either. Little 50-50 mind game going around this loop, and he is actually going to leave it just like that. Beautiful little dodge coming out of Sasuke, and you better believe that there is for sure a generator being proc on the other side of the map very, very soon. You can see here Tree Trick just saying, all right, fine, I'll just go for the M1, but he is so, so far away from anything he wants to be at. But is this going to be a fresh hook? It is, and that means another pain risk stack is about to come through. It's looking really bad for Tree Trick right now, though.
It really does, yeah. He was in a good position still, and he was getting the downs and the injuries. So we talked about how Luminescence generator efficiency definitely dropped here. But now, yeah, this is two generators. Now, in the mid-game, it took a little bit too long. So, absolutely insane. I don't even think Tree Trick realizes in what a difficult spot he is right now. I don't think he's going to expect two generators to pop. He is busy with preventing a head-on stun that is not going to happen, because the other generators are being repaired cross-map. So, that's going to be the fresh hook there with Sasuke, but that's going to be it very soon. Just a few more percentages, and then we are there with the final generator.
Yeah, we definitely are. And you can see here Zanami also willing to take a hit, and the last generator does get done, and Tree Trick probably in disbelief. He was having PTSD moments because a locker was staring at him. He thought maybe there was an Adam in there. That was definitely the person he wanted to find, but that just isn't the case right now. And having four people escape with all the generators done, that would be beautiful here for the side of Luminescence. That would mean so, so much pressure coming in on the next game for the survivors of Divine Dead. Can he get this one? It should be free. Yes, it is indeed going to be Zanami, going to be the sacrificial lamb. I feel like I don't know if there's anything at all that they want to do. Nope, they're completely content with the three-man escape. A lot better than they had last time, where they got 4k1. This time around, three people escaping. Beautiful play by Luminescence.
Crazy change. Also, we need to keep in mind this was back-to-back trials, and Tree Trick dropped from a 4k with two generators remaining to three men out with six stages. Like the turn Luminescence did in back-to-back trials, using one break to set up trial 7, pulling in a new strategy, talking across the team and coming in with something new, and then pulling this 180 turn result is absolutely insane. From 12 stages down to 6, and even all generators done. So absolutely insane, ladies and gentlemen. We will see you after a short break.
Welcome back, everybody. Yocat from Luminescence is now on the Deathslinger, and he just needs two kills, basically, to get this win secured in the bag for Luminescence. And I feel like that's a little bit more of a doable and manageable task than we had in the last set before the tie came in, Dyer. What do you think?
Absolutely, yeah, especially with the swing from a 4k into three-man escape. That was so wonderfully played by Luminescence, and the killer is coming in with the sheesh snipes at the beginning. Very, very beautiful shot onto God Khan, and that's now going to be a very unexpected chase for that survivor, because I do think he was confident that he was in safety there. So he needs to stay a little bit alive, otherwise Divine Dead even more in trouble.
Yeah, the life coming in here. The shot is going to connect here, though. Is he going to be able to get the lunge over? Nope, not going to be the case. Another vault goes over this time around. Gotcon is in a much, much worse place, though. There's no pallet to save him here. He might just go into a corner of some sort. No, he's just going to try to run the tile again. And this time, he goes down. Definitely good job by Gotcon, though. He actually made it a little bit harder than it might have needed to be here for Yokat. And he is looking desperately for a pain rest stack. And I don't believe this is it. Nope, it is not. So no gen regression going down right now. But this is probably going to be either a tunnel out or a camp out. I don't know what you think, Dire.
Yeah, even a camp out would be possible with how quick the down came through. We do see two people working on one generator. That would be a good first start. But other than that, Divine Dead definitely not in the dominating position here. And they're even not dictating how this game is going to start. We do see them here on the hill with their generator. And now it's actually two generators. So Divine Dead a little bit more efficient than it looked in the first place. And that's really important now, because Gotcon will then potentially be sacrificed at least into the second stage here. But having a response with two generators is a good start. But we need to keep in mind, we are talking about only seven stages for the win condition this time.
Yeah, exactly. And obviously, seven stages is much more doable than we were talking about in the last trials that we had with the 4K stages. Oh, but I believe that Divine Dead, to be able to get three men out, is going to be very, very tough for them. They kind of just have to keep being on these gens right now, or they have to try and get an unhook here. And it looks like they're actually lining up for an unhook more than anything, Dire.
Absolutely. That's not going to be anyone around here. We do see that it's going to be potentially the full camp into the 30 remaining seconds. And that's now going to be the next generator. Yokadex not able to hit that survivor. We do see them in the distance a bit lurking, but I do agree. Actually they are going for it, but I don't think that was the plan here with taking the injury before.
No, it definitely wasn't, but this could be much more than just an injury. This could just be the tunnel out into the kill. He is trying to stop him from getting moved. And this is beautiful body blocking coming in here from Menox, making sure that he isn't going to go down just yet, Gotcon, that is. And now, maybe a little bit of frustration coming out here on from Yokat. I mean, it shouldn't really be onto Menox, I feel like. I feel like he should either just go back and hook Kurzep, or he should just straight up go after Gotcon still.
Now going for a few shots here, none of them finding the target. That's the difficult thing, but hitting eventually over the box here. That's going to be the down you are looking for. Going to break the chain here to make it a little bit quicker and just force them into the open onto Undead. That's going to be just a few more seconds into the comp corner. And now we are going to see the down. Good job here by Yokarex, but Divine Dead still, I would say, in a good spot. They just need to take care about the injuries, which they this time do.
They definitely do. Menox already getting healed up here, but Gotcon is definitely the priority target to be healed up. I feel like that is the guy who can be tunneled out as of right now and get sacrificed already. Three hook states, however, is already guaranteed for if he does find Gotcon, because that is going to be the sacrifice that he is looking for. But I don't know if this is the correct play here from Yokat. I feel like he should have just gone from Gotcon and made sure that that guy at least was getting sent out of the trial immediately. But he wanted more. He was getting a little bit more greedy.
A little bit more greedy. Yeah, that's the point here. You need to make sure that you always find the perfect balance between your objectives, between your next step, between resets, between hooks, and all of this needs to be really, really in place. The difficult thing is that our killer didn't manage so far to get anyone eliminated here. And as long as you're facing four survivors, that's going to be the difficult task for you. And we also see that the survivors this time, and this is what I like to see, that Divine Dead is taking the more safe approach, because I think compared to earlier trials, we can see that this is paying out for them so far.
Definitely is. I mean, we do have the second stage going in on Undead, and if it should be the kill, it's going to be five stages straight off there and six with Gotcon, so not too bad as of right now. And we do see the pre-running coming in instantly the second that the heartbeat does get into the line of sight of anyone who was over there trying to do that generator. two gens are very, very close to this hook, so that is beautiful. The three gen is not exactly what he would like to have, but it's something that he just has to make do with right now.
Undead is going to be very dead in a few seconds here. 20 or 15 from now. Kirsep, Menox, and Godkan, they're all healthy. We would be at 5 stages when this elimination is coming through. So 2 more stages are needed to go for the next one. Let's see if Yokalex is able to pull that out. Let's see if he's able to pull that out before all the generators are completed. We see a little bit of progress over here, but even more on that generator. On 2 generators, if I wasn't mistaken, that is 80% at least on one generator right there in the distance. We do see Godkan hiding here as well, so at least one more generator will pop, but Divine Dead needs to be incredibly careful now with the remaining chases and stages.
Oh, they definitely do, and remember, this Noed is also going to be activated very, very soon, so that's going to be the trap card coming out straight away. No pain res value this game, unfortunately. Had that been the case with either of those hook states, he could have bought himself a little bit more time, perhaps. And if we do have another generator about to being popped, that's going to be big, big problems here on the other side of Luminescence, unless they can find the Noed totem instantly and then get 3 men out. Then we would actually just go for another retrial, because they're playing so neck and neck at the moment.
And that's now going to be the rotation back towards the generator, at least a peek. You need to make sure that you get all of this. But yeah, the 3 gen here is kind of something you can work with, at least with this outside generator here on the Wreckers. Yet you can at least control a little bit which survivor can move in and who can move out of that part of the map. It's not the best setup for sure, but you can still maybe make something out of it. Yokalex always looking a little bit, trying to catch the survivor in his back. He knows though that the survivors are already going towards these generators, so it's going to be a back and forth, and I feel like whichever side is going to be a little bit too greedy is going to take the punishment here.
Yeah, definitely might be the case. Kurzab here is sprinting away from all the generators, trying to get as far away as he can, possibly. But I think Yokat is actually completely fine by chasing this, because no generator had immense amount of progress on them. So he'll be completely fine to try to chase this off and try to see if he can get Kurzab onto a pain res hook and then maybe go back to the 3-gen situation and see what he can assess over there afterwards. Not sure if Kurzab has anything to do over here. He is going to get shot right here. Can he actually make the lunge around? I don't believe so. Oh, he was actually trying to predict the vault, but it was just a little bit too early. Had he waited a split second more, it would have come through for sure. The vault not going in, but here is the last generator proccing, actually. And this is big issues here. Beautiful firecracker coming in as well. Does he know where the Ada went? Kurzab is trying to get the vault off here. He isn't going to. And that's maybe the Noed actually spotted out now. Maybe they can get the 2-man escape, but that's not enough. They need the 3-man.
They will need the 3-man. Yeah, Kirsip now going to be thrown onto the hook. That's going to be hook stage number 6. No one escapes death immediately removed, but this is a fresh hook. So they need to save this, and they all need to leave out of the door. If Kirsip is going into the second stage, that would be confirmed. So, yeah, tough condition. Tough condition here for Divine Dead. They have to come in and try to rescue, but with only 2 survivors that can throw themselves in, and the door being cross map, because this one over here you will definitely not get open in time. That's going to be very difficult.
It's definitely going to be difficult. It's almost going to be impossible for them. They somehow need to get Kurzab off of the hook in the next 20 seconds or so. If they're not able to do that, that is going to be the game over here for Divine Dead. And we do see one hit going over at the very least. Godkan is also going to take a hit. Is he going to be the one to go down? He does actually juke down. They need to juke more shots than this, though. This is not enough as of right now. He can just hold W and cut someone off for sure. I don't believe he needs to take this shot. He should just keep holding W to get it, and he does indeed get Kurzab. This is going to be the final nail in the coffin, and it's going to be Luminescence making sure that they get the win. And what a long night it has been for them, but beautifully fought by both teams, honestly, Dire. I don't think that it could have been any closer than this.
Absolutely, and the time Yokalex took for that final shot, right? Like, you could literally see that he knew, if I miss this shot, we are going into the next tiebreaker, into trial number 9. He needed this shot onto the survivor. He aimed a little bit longer, but he eventually got it. But what a pressure that must have been, seeing the survivor run towards the exit gate.